welcome back to Chiromax. Today, I'm talking about how you may be hurting your organic reach. This is my nucleus here, and we're gonna talk about all these different electrons, so to speak, that are floating around. You might not be doing all of these, you may be doing part of these, but specifically today, we're talking about your organic reach on Facebook. You've probably noticed that when you post to Facebook as from your chiropractic page, it's being seen by very few people. And that is a trend that's only going to get bigger. There's a number of reasons for it. The quick reason is just that Facebook has a lot of content on it. And there's a lot of companies out there who are competing for those top spaces, or any space really, on a person's newsfeed. And Facebook, in trying to keep their users interested in the content, is only showing the content that they deem worthwhile. So that is why some of your content is probably not showing up. Because just by being a page, yours is not as valuable as when one of your patient's friends posts that they are engaged. You know, that kind of thing is gonna show up more likely, much more likely, than a post from your chiropractic practice. But now that I said all that, it's not all doom and gloom, and that's why we're talking about this today. You may be hurting your organic reach, but I have tips for bringing that reach back up. Okay, so let's dive into it. The first thing I want to talk about is all these down here. They're all kind of related to content. Let me start over here. Not being selective about what you post. This is me being nice and saying, not being selective. Really what this is saying is if you're posting garbage, it's not being shared. So don't post just anything. Make sure you're posting quality content. We've talked about that so many times. It's one of the key things really about anything in marketing, whether you're sending out an email newsletter or posting a blog or any content to your website, it all should be quality content. So especially on Facebook, you will be rewarded, and more so you will be punished if you are posting content that isn't of high caliber. Okay, now let's move over to here. Not sharing engaging material. So there are basically three different types of posts you can do on Facebook. You could have just text. You could have a text with a link to a website. And you could have a text with some kind of media. Within media, there's also the two options of either video or imagery. Let's focus on imagery right now because I'll be talking about video in a second. So, of those three, the media, posting a photo with your post, is going to be more engaging than just having a link or just having a straight sentence, we'll say. That's not to say you should only post one or the other, because anything, if you do it too much, gets old. However, if you post engaging material, people are more likely to comment and share, and those two things boost your organic reach. First of all, if somebody shares, that's being shared to that person's own audience, which means you are organically getting an exponential amount of growth from all those new sets of eyes that are seeing it from each individual share. And if somebody comments, Facebook rewards those posts that have a lot of comments by putting them in people's news feeds. So even if you're not doing an image, try posting a photo. Like, hey, if you have a piece of advice for new chiropractic patients, what would it be? Share with us here. And then hopefully that kind of post garners a lot of interaction, and that would end up then higher up on the news feed. Now, I mentioned video previously, and now is when I want to talk about it a lot. We just recently finished up a post about video on our blog. I'll leave a link here or here, I forget which corner it is, to get to those blog posts easily, because Video is huge. You should definitely be doing video, and especially on Facebook, because video is rewarded on Facebook. Facebook likes when businesses post video. Along with that is Facebook Live. Facebook Live is rewarded very well in Facebook's algorithm as well. So if you're not using Facebook Live, and at minimum not posting video, then you could be hurting your organic reach. Now, Facebook Live, this is probably a little bit riskier for you right now, but I would urge you to give it a try. It doesn't hurt anything, especially if you put thought into it, you plan in advance, and well, you can always use us for help too. So try incorporating these things into your content, and you're probably going to see your organic reach start to go up. Okay, now I actually want to go over to this one over here, back on this side. Here's another piece, seemingly simple, but it actually takes person-to-person contact, and that is just encouraging your patients to like the page, to turn on notifications for your page, which they specifically have to do if they want notifications when you post something. So I have a post actually on the blog about this too, so if you want more specific steps on that, head to the blog. Again, I'll leave a link so you can get to it. And then encouraging them to share, like, comment, all of that in person. If you put this out in person, they're much more likely to actually do it, especially if, as you've been growing your practice, you've been engaging people and providing a good service, which of course you have been. Now, going on to this one here, not treating Facebook as an advertising platform. So here's the unfortunate, depending on which way you look at it, truth. Facebook is becoming an advertising platform entirely for businesses itself. So you should no longer use Facebook just for organic reach, because over time that's going to go way down. Facebook says it could be at zero, that you will be reaching zero people if you are not using advertising. There are many ways to advertise on Facebook. Boosting your posts is one easy way. Using campaigns, running specific campaigns through Facebook, that's another easy way. And I encourage you to start using advertising while it's relatively young, because as you get more comfortable with it, you'll get more used to it and better at it. And that way you'll know how to be using it for when organic reach is way, way down. So this is basically me saying, here's the thing, you're probably not going to be getting much organic reach, but that's okay because Facebook has a great advertising platform. And it really does, it is a good advertising platform. That's another thing that we've talked about on the blog. So you should probably just go to the blog now because, as I've said, we have good content there. Lastly, my last comment here is not investing in your other channels. So first of all, other platforms like Instagram, owned by Facebook, so take that into account, but Twitter, Pinterest, YouTube, there's so many platforms out there. Use other platforms and diversify your efforts. And on top of social platforms, make sure you're investing time into your owned properties. That specifically is your website and your blog. This can also go into account with your email newsletters. So yeah, maybe your organic reach is going down on Facebook, but that's okay because you have so many ways to reach people these days. And at the end of the day, you own your website, you own your blog, and only you can control the content that is being pushed out on those channels. So if you commit to it and do it right, those are going to improve your organic reach over time as well. And that sums up how you are possibly hurting your organic reach. I mentioned blog multiple times, so I don't think I have to do it again here, but visit that if you would like further clarification on some of these. Otherwise, reach out to us at kyramox.com on our contact page. We'll be back again in another week. and we look forward to seeing you then. Have a good weekend. Bye.